Ever since his 2016 presidential campaign, there has been a lot of talk about whether or not Bernie Sanders is actually a socialist. He describes himself as a democratic socialist, but most of the policies he champions are social democratic in nature. And when asked, he always denies to be for the nationalization of the means of production. Therefore, the current discussion centers mostly around the question of whether or not democratic socialism has come to take on a different meaning. But really, I think this avoids the important question, which is whether or not Bernie Sanders supports the collectivization of the means of production. You see, originally, socialism was all about collectivization of the means of production. This means that the workers should run the factories that they work in. Now, because Russia and China had such an enormous success in marketing themselves as communist and socialist, socialism has slowly taken over another meaning, which is the meaning that it is about the nationalization of the means of production, which is very different and not very useful from a libertarian socialist perspective, or from even originally socialist perspective, because it doesn't really matter whether the boss you have is a private person or a state employee. The important question is whether you have a boss or whether you decide your own fate. Now, when asked, Bernie Sanders has never supported the nationalization of the means of production, but he has often spoken about the collectivization of the means of production throughout his whole career, and he has always spoken positively about it. So, here are some quotes from him. Democracy means public ownership of the major means of production. It means decentralization. It means involving people in their work. Rather than having bosses and workers, it means having democratic control over the factories and shops as to as great a degree as you can. Another one. All that socialism means to me, to be very frank with you, is democracy with a small d. I believe in democracy, and by democracy I mean that, to as great an extent as possible, human beings have the right to control their own lives. And that means that you cannot separate the political structure from the economic structure. One has to be an idiot to believe that the average working person who is making 10,000 or 12,000 a year is equal in political power to somebody who is the head of a large bank or corporation. So if you believe in political democracy, if you believe in equality, you have to believe in economic democracy as well. Many people go to school, but most of them don't challenge the basic assumptions of the teachers or of the system. And I always have. You reach a certain age when you start reading reasonably widely and you find ideas that reflect your gut feeling about something. I think that's usually the process. You find what you're looking for. I had that feeling when I first read Eugene Debs, for example. If you read what Debs said about the goals of socialism, it's no different from what I've been saying. That all socialism about is democracy. And a very explicit one. I believe that in the long run, major industries in the state and nation should be publicly owned and controlled by the workers themselves. These various quotes have been gathered in a Reddit thread, which I have linked to below. And, well, I think it's pretty clear that Bernie actually supports the collectivization of the means of production. Of course, he doesn't really talk about that right now, which I think is because he's running for president and he's trying to move the needle. So in a talk he gave in Berlin shortly after his 2016 presidential campaign, he was asked about a universal basic income, and his basic answer was that, yeah, he supports it in theory, but he believes the current political climate is just not ready right now. And I think he believes that about a lot of things, and he is trying to move the needle. So you can see that when other people started adopting his policies, like healthcare for all, Medicare for all, then he started getting less well-known and less mainstream policies into the mix, like federal jobs guarantee, which is something a lot of socialists would like to see. And so I think that's his basic strategy, that he doesn't see any possibility to just suddenly jump from an almost totally capitalist system to a system which has actual democratic controls of the means of production. And yeah, when he was asked by Amy Goodman in a Democracy Now! Interview, also after 2016, he cited two major inspirations. One was Martin Luther King, and the other one was Eugene Debs. Eugene Debs, of course, is one of the most famous socialists in history. And you can find these quotes about collectivization of the means of production throughout his entire career. I don't think it's really opportunistic to start the dialogue at a point where most people are and slowly evolve it to a point where you are. I think it is something that needs to happen because when you start at your own premises and just assume that everyone believes what you believe, you won't ever get a discussion going. So, this is basically my case. I believe Bernie Sanders is actually a socialist, a real socialist, not some kind of capitalist with that wants to smooth the edges somewhat. And I think it is pretty clear once you look at his actual at the actual things he is saying or he has said. Let's read one more quote. I like this one. Human beings can own the means of production and work together rather than having to work as semi-slaves to other people who can hire and fire. That sounds socialist. I want you to subscribe and click the bell. Also, I want your questions and your feedback. You can send them to me by Facebook, by Twitter, and by email. The links are below. Thank you for your time.